There once lived a king and a queen, as many a one has been. They were long married and had no children. But at last a baby boy came to the queen when the king was away in the far countries. The queen would not christen the boy till the king came back, and she said, "We will just call him Nix Not Nothing until his father comes home." But it was long before he came home, and the boy had grown a fine, bonny laddie. At length the king was on his way back, but he had a big river to cross, and there was a whirlpool, and he could not get over the water. But a giant came up to him, and said, "I'll carry you over." But the king said, "What's your pay?" "Oh, give me Nix, not nothing, and I will carry you over the water on my back." The king had never heard that his son was called Nix Not Nothing, and so he said, "Oh, I'll give you that and my thanks into the bargain." When the king got home again, he was very happy to see his wife again, and his young son. She told him that she had not given the child any name, but just Nix Not Nothing, until he should come home again himself. The poor king was in a terrible case. He said, "What have I done? I promised to give the giant who carried me over the river on his back Nix Not Nothing." The king and the queen were sad and sorry, but they said, "When the giant comes, we will give him the hen wife's boy. He will never know the difference." The next day the giant came to claim the king's promise, and he sent for the hen wife's boy, and the giant went away with the boy on his back. He traveled till he came to a big stone, and there he sat down to rest. He said, "Hidge, hodge, on my back, what time of day is that?" The poor little lad said, "It is the time that my mother, the hen wife, takes up the eggs for the queen's breakfast." Then the giant was very angry, and dashed the boy on the stone and killed him. Back he went in a tower of a temper, and this time they gave him the gardener's boy. He went off with him on his back till they got to the stone again, when the giant sat down to rest. And he said, "Hidge, hodge, on my back, what time of day do you make that?" The gardener's boy said, "Surely, it's the time that my mother takes up the vegetables for the queen's dinner." Then the giant was as wild as could be, and killed him, too. Then the giant went back to the king's house in a terrible temper, and said he would destroy them all if they did not give him Nix Not Nothing this time. They had to do it, and when he came to the big stone, the giant said, "What time of day is that?" Nix Not Nothing said, "It is the time that my father the king will be sitting down to supper." The giant said, "I've got the right one now," and took Nix Not Nothing to his own house and brought him up till he was a man. The giant had a bonny daughter, and she and the lad grew very fond of each other. The giant said one day to Nix Not Nothing, "I've work for you tomorrow. There is a stable 7 miles long and 7 miles broad, and it has not been cleaned for 7 years. And you must clean it tomorrow, or I will have you for my supper." The giant's daughter went out next morning with the lad's breakfast, and found him in a terrible state, for always as he cleaned out a bit, it just fell in again. The giant's daughter said she would help him, and she cried all the beasts in the field, and all the fowls in the air, and in a minute they all came, and carried away everything that was in the stable and made it all clean before the giant came home. He said, "Shame on the wit that helped you, but I have a worse job for you tomorrow." Then he said to Nix Not Nothing, "There's a lake 7 miles long, and 7 miles deep, and 7 miles broad, and you must drain it tomorrow by nightfall, or else I'll have you for my supper." Nix Not Nothing began early next morning and tried to lave the water with his pail, but the lake was never getting any less, and he didn't know what to do. But the giant's daughter called on all the fish in the sea to come and drink the water, and very soon they drank it dry. When the giant saw the work done, he was in a rage, and said, "I've a worse job for you tomorrow. There is a tree, 7 miles high, and no branch on it, till you get to the top, and there is a nest with 7 eggs in it, and you must bring down all the eggs without breaking one, or else I'll have you for my supper." At first the giant's daughter did not know how to help Nix Not Nothing, but she cut off first her fingers and then her toes, and made steps of them, and he climbed the tree and got all the eggs safe till he came just to the bottom, and then one was broken. So they determined to run away together, and after the giant's daughter had gone back to her room and got her magic flask, they set out together as fast as they could run. And they hadn't got but 3 fields away when they looked back and saw the giant walking along at full speed after them. "Quick! Quick!" called out the giant's daughter. "Take my comb from my hair and throw it down." Nix Not Nothing took her comb from her hair and threw it down, and out of every one of its prongs there sprung up a fine thick briar in the way of the giant. You may be sure it took him a long time to work his way through the briar bush, and by the time he was well through, Nix Not Nothing and his sweetheart had run far, far away from him. But he soon came along after them, and was just like to catch him up when the giant's daughter called out to Nix Not Nothing, "Take my hair dagger and throw it down, quick, quick!" So Nix Not Nothing threw down the hair dagger, and out of it grew, as quick as lightning, a thick hedge of sharp razors placed crisscross. The giant had to tread very cautiously to get through all this, and meanwhile they both ran hard, and on, and on, and on, till they were nearly out of sight. But at last the giant was through, and it wasn't long before he was like to catch them up. But just as he was stretching out his hand to catch Nix Not Nothing, his daughter took out her magic flask and dashed it on the ground. And as it broke, out of it welled a big, big wave that grew, and that grew, till it reached the giant's waist and then his neck, and when it got to his head, he was drowned dead, and dead, and dead indeed. But Nix Not Nothing fled until where do you think they came to? Why, to near the castle of Nix Not Nothing's father and mother. But the giant's daughter was so weary that she couldn't move a step further. So Nix Not Nothing told her to wait there while he went and found out a lodging for the night. And he went on towards the lights of the castle, and on the way he came to the cottage of the hen wife whose boy, you'll remember, had been killed by the giant. Now she knew Nix Not Nothing in a moment, and hated him because he was the cause of her son's death. So when he asked his way to the castle, she put a spell upon him, and when he got to the castle, no sooner was he led in than he fell down dead asleep upon a bench in the hail. The king and queen tried all they could do to wake him up, but all in vain, so the king promised that if any maiden could wake him, she could marry him. Meanwhile the giant's daughter was waiting and waiting for him to come back, and she went up into a tree to watch for him. The gardener's daughter, going to draw water in the well, saw the shadow of the lady in the water and thought it was herself, and said, "If I'm so bonny, if I'm so brave, why do you send me to draw water?" So she threw down her pail and went to see if she could wed the sleeping stranger. And she went to the hen wife, who taught her an unspelling charm which would keep Nix Not Nothing awake as long as the gardener's daughter liked. So she went up to the castle and sang her charm, and Nix Not Nothing was wakened for a while, and they promised to wed him to the gardener's daughter. Meanwhile the gardener went down to draw water from the well and saw the shadow of the lady in the water. So he looked up and found her, and he brought the lady from the tree, and led her into his house. And he told her that a stranger was to marry his daughter, and took her up to the castle and showed her the man. And it was Nix Not Nothing asleep in a chair. And she saw him, and she cried to him, "Waken, waken, and speak to me." But he would not waken, and soon she cried, "I cleaned the stable, I laved the lake, and I clomb the tree, and all for the love of thee, and thou wilt not waken and speak to me." The king and queen heard this, and came to the bonny young lady, and she said, "I cannot get Nix Not Nothing to speak to me, for all that I can do." Then were they greatly astonished when she spoke of Nix Not Nothing, and asked where he was, and she said, "He that sits there in that chair." Then they ran to him and kissed him and called him their own dear son. So they called for the gardener's daughter and made her sing her charm, and he wakened, and told them all that the giant's daughter had done for him, and of all her kindness. Then they took her in their arms and kissed her, and said she should now be their daughter, for their son should marry her. But as for the hen wife, she was put to death. And they lived happy all their days.